My name is Dave Thule. This is Travis Quinlan. We're both constituents and Iraq War vets. We're hoping to talk to someone about a photograph I have of Tommy from the Walls.
Okay.
Not sure if you have ever seen this picture before.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, in it, it depicts 2004 being in Afghanistan.
Right.
Tommy from the Walls is not an Afghanistan war veteran, is he?
He served in Italy as part of Operation Enduring Freedom.
Okay, but he didn't serve in Afghanistan, did he?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay. Hi, Rick. I'm Dave Thule. How you doing?
Nice to meet you, Dave.
There's a young lady in the other office that was helping us, but if you can.
You guys want to come in and have a seat?
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, have a seat.
Hi, I'm Dave Thule. This is Travis Quinlan. We're both,
hi, Doc.
We're both constituents, and we're both Iraq War vets. We serve together.
Okay.
With the Minnesota National Guard. So we're here on a veteran-related issue. I don't know if you are familiar with this picture at all. This was taken in 2004 here in Mankato, and it's actually been posted on the internet for quite some time, and nobody quite realized what it is. But in this picture, Congressman Walls here is holding a sign that says "Enduring Freedom, Veterans for Care." So tell me what your understanding of his military background is.
Yeah, I understand that he was called up in support of it. Obviously, in support of that operation. That's how I've always understood it. And so the time that he, when he got called up, I guess I've always referred to it as, was called up and served in support of Operation Enduring Freedom.
Okay. So is there any question in your mind what Enduring Freedom is?
No.
Okay. So I guess most people, and yourself included, would associate Enduring Freedom with Afghanistan.
Right, but okay. I mean, I think it, as I also understand that it encompasses a great deal.
Well, Operation Enduring Freedom is limited to Afghanistan and the airspace directly above. There's other units that are called up in support of, and I'm sure that's probably what his military orders said.
Right.
My concern, other than this picture, is that the congressman's website, his official biography, says simply that he was mobilized within the battalion in support of Operation Enduring Freedom. Without any other details, don't you think it's reasonable people might assume that means he served in Afghanistan?
Perhaps, I guess.
Okay. So it's been 5 years now, or I guess almost 5 years, that the congressman's official biography has said he served in support of Operation Enduring Freedom. Is that reasonable if it causes confusion, or it may cause confusion, that somebody may have thought to change that and explain that he served in Italy and not in Afghanistan?
I mean, what would you suggest it be changed to, I guess?
Simply to add the words "in Italy." Served in support of Operation Enduring Freedom in Italy. Simple as that, because then it specifies that he served in Italy. Now, don't get me wrong, I certainly appreciate the congressman's service. 24 years in the National Guard, we're both National Guardsmen ourselves. We appreciate his service, and we appreciate his being deployed. But there's a huge difference between being deployed to a base in Italy and being in the combat zone in Afghanistan. Okay. Are you aware of any of the media reports from 2006 that inaccurately cited the congressman as a war veteran?
Specifically, I can't think of any right now, but I don't. I would imagine that. I know people have approached me as a staffer and thought that, and so I've corrected them. If you serve in support of an operation, you're not necessarily a veteran of that operation.
Exactly.
Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
So your question is more about this picture than his biography.
I have two questions.
Yeah.
The biography is one of them. That's bad. That's misleading. That's a little bad. This right here, under current U.S. law, this could get the congressman probably thrown in jail in violation of the 2006 Stolen Valor Act, which says it is a crime, a federal crime, to portray yourself in writing or verbally as having received an award or decoration authorized by Congress that you didn't receive. Congressman Walls is clearly claiming in this sign, in this picture with this sign, to be an Enduring Freedom veteran. He is clearly, nobody disputes the fact that he is not an Afghanistan or Enduring Freedom veteran. So this represents a fairly serious issue. So can I leave you my name and number, and can I trust that someone will get back to me on this issue?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, let me grab it.
Dave, was it?
Yes.
How do you spell your last name?
Thul, T-H-U-L.
And you're from Motown, you said?
Yes.
Okay. Did you want to leave any of this?
Yes, I'm going to leave this for you. This is a copy of the picture, so you guys have exactly what I'm looking at. And this is a copy of the story that I'm working off of. I'm also a blogger, and it's opposed to this. So I will leave you with all the information there that is relevant to this. And I'll leave you with a copy of the picture, and I will hope to hear from someone in the congressman's office, if not the congressman, because this is a fairly serious matter, and it needs to be addressed.
Okay. And you posted this then? This is posted online?
Yes, it's posted on Monday.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you very much. I appreciate your help and cooperation.
Thank you. Thank you for your service as well. We definitely appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Your name again?
Travis.
Travis?